they are invoking the Lord. Basic rituals are all about invoking the Lord. Instead of invoking Him inside us, we are invoking Him outside of us. Therefore, we need Him over there in front of us. What do we, that divine principle which is there in each one of us, we are now going to externalize Him. So from within us, it's basically like taking the Lord out of us and placing Him there in front of us. We can, and for that we need a substance. We need a vastu. It can be a granite stone, it can be marble, it can be a picture, it can be a kalasha, it can be in any form. So therefore we place the Lord outside of us for the time being when we are going through our puja or when we are going through rituals. And whatever we want to do, our puja, we do it there to Him, out there, not within us. So we invoke Him over there in that vastu over there. It's an ordinary stone or an ordinary picture. But in that, what are we invoking? We are invoking the ideal. We are invoking the divine principle. We are invoking the Brahman of the Upanishad. Paramatma, Parabrahma is whom we are invoking in that vastu over there. So therefore, we must be very clear that vastu there is not God. It only represents God for us. There is a difference between saying the idol is God and the idol represents God. Idol is not God. Stone cannot be God. But the idol over there represents God for me. And why does it represent? Because from within me, I have, for the time being, asked the Lord to go and stay over there. So there are mantras over there, chanting is there, there are certain mudras that they, you know, perform over there to make the Lord from within us to go and there sit for the time being when we are doing our puja. So therefore, with the help of all that, now we have placed the Lord outside of us. So the internal Lord, we have externalized Him. After all the puja is over or the homa is over, we bring Him back into us. And then we do the visarjana of the substance. That's how it is. So for the time being. Now when the Lord is over there in front of us and that vastu there substance represents Him, where should He be seated? Even normally we are asked not to sit on the ground. Something should be there between us and the ground for our puja also. So when we are going through the puja also, we sit on something. We don't sit on bare ground. We have to have something between us and Mother Earth. An insulator should be there. Lord also has to be seated on something. That's why we say asanam samarpayami. Lord, I offer to you a seat on which you should sit. So the asana can be anything. Again, it's just a substance. But all that we do, the rituals, our bhava should be okay. The state of our mind is very, very important in whatever we are going through. So therefore, we offer Him a seat. And where is the seat placed? Again, it's not an empty ground. Who is the Lord? He is Jagadishwara. He is the Lord of the universe. He is the one who has created the universe for us. Therefore, we always say, He is at the center of the universe. He is at the center of the universe. Therefore, when we make Him sit down, we must make Him sit down at the center of the universe. How to bring the universe over here into our homes and make Him sit over there? We draw the Rangoli design over there. So therefore, the concept of Rangoli becomes very, very important for us. It's a science by itself. We can't use whatever material we want. We can't use whatever colors we want. Any diagram design, it does not constitute a Rangoli. There are specific designs, the curves, etc., dots. How many lines should be there together? One strand or two strands or three strands. What is the material that I am using over there? This is all a big science. There is this whole science behind Rangoli over there. So therefore, we draw the Rangoli. Whether it is in the puja room or in the morning, outside of our house, first thing that we do is clean ourselves. We have gotten up, woken up, we clean up ourselves, take a bath, and the first thing that we do, even before the sun rises, is to go and put a design, Rangoli, in front of our house. What is it that we are doing over there? We are invoking Jagadishwara there, in and through the Rangoli there. What does the Rangoli represent? Jagat it represents. It represents universe over there. Universe Jagat plus Jagadishwara it represents. So the whole design that we have done, there should be a center to it. If the design represents the Jagat, the middle point, the dot there, represents Jagadishwara for us. That's why whenever we put a rangoli, we make sure that first we put a dot at the center. Then in and around the dot, we weave the beautiful pattern. So when we are doing it in the morning, this should be the bhava in us. It's not some design that I am putting over there. What to do, tradition has compelled me to do it and therefore I am doing it. No. Morning, we are invoking the Lord, Jagadishwara, and also therefore I am going to prostrate to him over there. Now he is never separate from his Jagat. He has created the universe and we are a part of it also. We are a part of the universe. So therefore when we put that beautiful design over there, the rangoli, the whole universe includes the universe of things and being, including ourselves there. So somewhere in the rangoli, we also have a part over, place over there. And the center over there represents the Lord. So on that we place the asana and make him sit over there. See, the concept is so beautiful. And in the morning when we do it, when we, even as we are drawing the rangoli, or we are unveiling that beautiful design, the bhava in us should be alright. Jagat and Jagadishwara is whom I am invoking. Jagat and its Ishwara, Jagadishwara, is whom I am invoking over here. So after putting the entire design, what should we do? We silently prostrate to it and then enter into our house. Morning, we Lord, we have invoked you, we have offered our salutations unto you and to the universe you have created. So automatically to all things and on all beings, we have sent in our reverence and respect. Then we enter into our house. Again with the salutations to the main door, because there is a whole Jagat and a universe inside our house also. So that is the meaning of the beautiful rangoli that we draw either in the house, in front of the house or in the puja. So therefore, where is the Lord sitting over there for the puja that we are doing? First of all, we have placed him, externalized him for the time being from ourselves over there in front of us. We have offered him a seat to sit down and also where the seat, it's on a rangoli. That's the meaning. That's why it's never empty. We always draw a design or a pattern. And also, outside way, rice flour we use, not harmful chemicals. Why? First thing in the morning, even before I eat, I am feeding the Lord's creation. And the insignificant, small little creatures, no, none of us think about them. Those are being taken care of over there. Therefore, the rice flour. And also, red mud we use, kimmannu we say in Kannada. So the combination of white and red, not red, brick red, is a very beautiful combination over there. It represents again Prakriti and Purusha. The dot represents Paramatma, one without a second. He alone has become Prakriti and Purusha. So Purusha is represented by the white, Prakriti is represented by matter, realm of matter she represents for us, that mud she represents over there. White also represents knowledge. Red represents activity. See, everything gets so beautifully taken care of over there. And also, the design over there that we put in the form of rangoli, I already said there is a science behind it. It cuts off all negative vibration from entering into our house. There is an outer space over there, outside of our house, wherein which we have no control over. Many things are happening over there. Nice things are happening, not nice things are happening. There is an inner space, our house, where we hope only nice things will happen. Rangoli is able to bar those negative vibrations from entering into our house. That's why we put the design also. Everything has got its own energy field and its own vibrations. That's why I said all designs will not make a rangoli. All colors will not make a rangoli. And all forms we can't lay out over there in front of our house or in the puja room. Specific designs only are used because the pattern there has got its own energy field and that we want it to be very, very positive for us. So therefore, the rangoli does a very beautiful job for us. It cuts off all negative vibration from entering into our house. See, one small little rangoli that we put in front of our house, what all benefits are. Morning, we become very sattvic. We have invoked the Lord, therefore we are thinking of Him. And instead of just thinking of I and mine, we are thinking of the whole universe. Therefore, expansion has already started over there. That's what a ritual is all about. Even drawing a rangoli is a ritual that we do. Every morning we do it. So this is about the rangoli. So the rangoli is there, Asanam is there, and the Lord is there. And we always like to see the Lord in our own image. Just as we are, we put Him over there. Whether it is Ganesha, whether it is Devi, Rama, Krishna, Shiva, Hanumanji, it doesn't matter. Names are different, forms are different, characteristics are different. And again, one thing which is very important is every dravya that is used, substance that is used, from the idol to whatever puja samagriya we are going to use, everything has got an importance by itself. Why we use whatever we are using and why not something else is very, very important also. It's just not take anything, we use anything, no. So therefore, all of that in detail we can't go through. Only some of them I'm going to go through now.